Just to make sure.
And just check that the microphone doesn't go way over. Was it opening on the?
It was. I changed it to here, but then it.
Okay. Well, you know, there's not much that can be done.
Okay, let's go back.
But is this even registering anything?
Well,
should flash green.
If you can play, and I'll be right back.
Okay. Few more minutes and then just go backstage.
Okay.
I'm good. It's like just after one.
Just like a minute?
Yeah, right at one.
Hey! Hi, how are you? How did you survive all that stuff in Colorado? Did you come as far as you got? Thank you. It's so much happiness to guide me over the 5 years. So I really learned a lot too.
Well, I'm staying in
Denver. Oh, you are?
Yeah, it could be so good in the family.
But for you, for you.
No problem.
Very much.
They want to get me to spend it. So it's one of these things that you spend it. So we'll see what happens.
Wow. Wow, what a nice crowd.
This is live stream, by the way.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Yes.
Or Rick, if you want to move up front, it's up to you. Okay. But thank you. Maybe another time. But thank you so much.
Yeah. Can I go grab a chair over there?
Yes, the only thing that is going to come in.
Oh.
Thank you.
It's a great pleasure to be back performing in Reno, and thanks to you watching on the live stream. I started out with a piece by Ravel sort of on the spur of the moment, because the composer I'll be performing next, Emmanuel Chabrier, is probably lesser known to the general public, so I want to give a little bit of context to how I discovered him and how to listen to his music. So regarding Chabrier, he's really best known for two works. One is his Orchestral Rhapsody España, which is very commonly played. And the second is actually this work by Ravel called In the Style of Chabrier. Mm-hmm. I had encountered this piece when I was younger and played through it. It's pretty short, not overly difficult. But I think anyone who plays it will wonder, well, what is the style of Chabrier? Chabrier was actually very influential on the next generation of French composers, like Debussy, Ravel, and then two generations later, Francis Poulenc. Now, Chabrier was a very iconoclastic figure. He was not trained in a conservatory. In fact, he was a lawyer until he wrote so much good music that he decided to become a composer full time. Now, this piece that I just played displays a few traits of Chabrier. It takes a pretty straightforward tune, but then goes out in a very discursive way of setting it. So you heard little flourishes, pauses, hesitations. Chabrier never liked his music to be straightforward. He liked it to take twists and turns. He liked it to be witty and unexpected. When the composer Vincent Dandy heard Chabrier play, he said Chabrier would make a lot of unexpected crescendos and tempo changes that weren't marked in the music. I think you'll hear that most in the first set piece I'm going to be playing, called Paysage or Landscape. That it's especially off kilter because every single phrase is three measures rather than four. So something will feel slightly off about it. And there will always be moments where the music stops to reflect on itself or goes in a different direction you'll not expect. Chabrier also had a very fluid sense of meter for the next two pieces, Melancholie and Tourbillon. It'll be very hard for anyone to guess the meter. If anyone can successfully guess the time signature of Melancholie, I'll be very impressed. And Tourbillon also, it's like a waltz that's gone a little bit out of control. Sometimes it'll feel like it's in three, sometimes it'll feel like it's in two. Sometimes you'll have a four measure phrase, sometimes you'll have three or five. And I think Chabrier was also very forward looking. He sort of, his piano music goes away from the very florid romantic writing to something more sparse and dry. You'll hear that especially in Melancholie and Idylle, which use very sparse pianistic textures to great effect. That being said, the fifth piece of the set I'm playing, Improvisation, is truly a romantic piece in the style of Schumann and Chopin, and it will bring about a very peaceful conclusion to the set. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
another theme of this concert is projects in progress. As you can see, I only played 5 out of the 10 pieces, but to save time, the whole set takes about 40 minutes. So someday I hope to play the whole set. They're really a wonderful set of pieces that I've never heard anyone perform them or anyone teach any of them. They're really fantastic pieces for, they would be fantastic pieces for talented young pianists too. Goyescas by Enrique Granados is a 6 or 7 movement. It's a, trying to think how many movements. 6 movement suite based on paintings by Goya, hence the name Goyescas. This sort of represents, in my opinion, the pinnacle of Romantic Spanish piano music, along with Iberia by Isaac Albéniz. And it's one of the prime examples of a symphonic poem or opera as an extended piano piece. In each of the 6 movements, the themes are recycled, so it tells a broader story. And it all culminates in a large ballade called Love and Death. This movement is called Fandango in Candlelight. The Spanish dance influence is very obvious. This piano piece was so successful that Granados actually turned the whole set into an opera, and quite remarkably, he preserved the entire music of the piano piece. So it really puts into perspective as a performer how you can interpret this more vocally and operatically, even though your fingers are flying all over the place. Tragically, after the U.S. premiere of the opera Goyescas, Granados, the ship that took him back to Europe, was torpedoed, and that's why he died at a very young age. Mm-hmm. And so we sort of miss what he could have done if he lived a little bit longer. So I hope you enjoy this very, it's quite a virtuosic piece.
Thank you.
I've met a lot of scientists. Oh, okay. So I've been working a lot in the lab and a lot of COVID testing.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
It's changed dramatically.
It has.
A couple of years
that you've been here. Yes. I mean, I look at the trend sometimes when cases are going really high or they're going low. It's been up and down. And now we're seeing more like flu cases. Yeah. Actually, there was a patient who ended up with influenza A and COVID at the same time. They tested positive for both, so I'm wondering how they are right now, but that's not really good.
Mm-hmm.
Which
group?
Which group?
The same, the term I used to put in the feeling, like it's the same term. It's funny, there is a term.
Sometimes called conflict.
No, it's a different term.
I don't remember. Yeah, they do take a term for that.
Very busy.
It's been very busy and.
Today, afternoon, it's worth the time.
I've been working a lot of overtime, yes.
So I don't need time.
We leave tomorrow morning.
You can visit my family.
Yes. It's been pretty nice. Because my work shifts, I work 7 days on and then 7 days off. So I'm off for 2 weeks. So, but of course it's the night show, so. So there's 7 on, sometimes can be a killer. But I mean, it's nice having a week off. If that is that I don't work overtime. Everyone. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's some times where I actually have to do two positions in one, like two departments. You can get two departments in one. And that's not easy. It's 420 beds, so it's I would say it's a big hospital, but there's another one that's around 600 and something. So it's about mid. It's a large hospital, but not as big as other ones that there are. But yes, we definitely always need more staff.
Yes. Because I think people when they see the case, but they respond.
Yeah, I mean, he shared the link and hopefully people can see it, but if not, it's still going to be on YouTube for anyone to see it. If they're not able to see it, then. He didn't tell me how long the pause was going. He didn't tell me how long the pause or the big pause was going to be. About maybe less than that, I would say. Less, yeah. We just did an approximate.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
you so much for coming today. I don't have energy for an encore, but you know, that was my first live run through of Chopin's 12 etudes. I hope to do that set a lot more, and also the next 12. So again, incomplete project. Thanks to you on the live stream as well, and I'll stay around to chat for a little bit, but great to see you all.
No way.